Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to see two operators which is used in SQL, that is between and in. Last few videos, we are watching about the classes and this is a continuation of the same. Now we are going to see about the between and in operators in queries. Okay, so let's move on to the topic. Here is a between operator. So let's see how the between operator is used in SQL. So this between operator always select the values within a given range. So in queries, we will give a range, okay? And the query will be, check whether the which record satisfying that particular range, which is lying between the range, that will be retrieved in the output, okay? So this between operator always select the values within a given range. User will specify the range in the query and that range will be satisfied. Whatever statement is satisfying the given range, that will be shown in the output. So let's see an example. And mostly the values whichever we are getting from the SQL between operator, it will be based on numbers, text or dates. Okay, so you can use a numbers, you can use a text in the sense of words or something else like that. Or else date, you can get in any format, okay? Any values can be retrieved by using this between operator. And the between operator is inclusive for begin and end values are included, okay? Begin and end values will be included in this between operator. So here is the syntax of between operator. The syntax is select column name. Here I have mentioned S inside the bracket. It means you can include more than one column also in your query. Okay, so select column name or names from a table name where column name between value 1 and value 2. So if you want to use between operator, you have to write that between after this where class. Okay, about this where class already we have seen in our previous videos. So if you didn't watch that video, please kindly go and watch that video. Then you can see this, if it will be easy for you to understand. So always between operator has to mention after the where class. Okay, so the syntax is select column name or else columns, then from table name where column name between the value 1 and value 2, and in the sense it is comes under and operator, that also we are going to see in our videos. So later on we will see about this and or not about this, we will see later. Just here you just learn the syntax of this between operator. Okay, so let's see the example and output of the between operator. Okay, here I have given a demo database. This is a product table. And here we have totally 6 attributes, that is product ID, product name, supplier ID, category ID, unit and price. So these are the attributes we have in our product table. Okay, just look at the queries which I have used here. Okay, so the between example, this whatever I have given as a query here, this is going to select all the product with the price between 10 and 20. Okay, I need a product's price, but it should be in the range between 10 and 20. Like for example, if you are using the Amazon app for online purchase or something else, if you want to see the list of things which you want to buy, then you can apply the filters, right? For example, if I want to buy a laptop, then I can give the filter as below 50,000. I just want a list. My budget is only 50,000. So I need what are the laptops are available under this condition. So below 50,000 rupees. So I can give this query, right? Like that it will be worked. So that is also a kind of a database, right? So you can manage the things in such case you can use this between operator. Okay, so just look at here, select star from products where price between 10 and 20. So I have to select all the attributes. Here I have used star symbol, so it shows that it will retrieve all the attributes. Okay, not only specified attribute, it will select all the attributes in the record. And from the product table, so the table name we have mentioned, where in that product table where price should be between 10 and 20. Okay, so this is a query I have given here. Let's see what is the output of this query. So it should be within a range. Okay, so here is the output of our given query. So as we have mentioned, our price should be 10 and 20, between 10 and 20 we have mentioned. So only the three records is retrieved from the product table. So here is the price is 10, 19 and 18. So between 10 and 20 we have asked, and we got the list of the products which are available between 10 and 20. The price is between 10 and 20. So let's move on to the next one. Now not between. Already we have seen that between operator, right? So now we are going to see not between. Not between in the sense out of the range. Not in the range, out of the range. For example, the same query if you have taken between 10 and 20 we have taken, no. So if I have used not between 10 and 20, then that particular records alone will not be displayed in the output. Okay, so let's see. Here is an example. The same thing. The same query I have used. Select star from products where price not between 10 and 20. Already we have used for between. We have just given between 10 and 20. Now here we have given not between 10 and 20. Let's see what is the output of this given query. So the output is, just look at here. First one we have retrieved 1, 2, 3 records, right? Now here is a 4 and 5 record, which the price is, the price of the product is, here is 21 rupees and 35 pies, and here is a 22 rupees. Because we have used the operator not between. So we have given the condition not between 10 to 20, 10 and 20. So whatever price is available between 10 and 20 will not be displayed during output. Okay, so likewise we can use the between operator in SQL. Okay, so let's see what is the in operator that we are using in the SQL. Okay, so this in operator allows the user to test whether the expression matches any value in the list of values. Okay, for example, it is used to remove the need of multiple OR condition. Because in the previous query also we have seen that, no, AND. So AND condition we have used in the statement, in the query. So likewise, OR statement can also be used in the query. So if you want to avoid more number of OR, you can use this IN operator, okay, to reduce the number of OR condition in the SELECT statement, or else INSERT statement, or else update statement or delete statement, whatever. Okay, select, insert, update or delete. In whatever queries, if you want to reduce the number of OR condition, you can use this IN operator. Instead of using more OR condition, you can use this IN operator. Okay, so let's see the example, then it will be easy for you to understand. And here, as a between, we have seen, no, between operator and not between operator. Likewise, you can use IN operator and not IN operator. Okay, this not IN operator to exclude the rows in your list. Whatever you have listed, that will not be displayed while during the output. Okay, so like the same, whatever we have seen in the between statement, the same, but the process will be different. Okay, so let's see the syntax of IN operator. So the syntax is select column name or columns name from table name where column name in list of values. Okay, there we have mentioned that two datas. No, between means the beginning and the end we will mention. Sometimes we need to give more than one condition, right? At that time we have to use the or statement. So instead of using more or condition, we are giving the list of values. Okay, let's see the example based on this syntax. So here is an example. for this OR operator, sorry, IN operator. Here is an example, select product ID. So select product ID and product name. So two attributes we are going to retrieve from the given table. So select product ID and product name from product table where price in 10 and 18. Okay. Output is, just look at here, only the product ID and product name we will get, not all the attributes. Whatever we have mentioned in the example, sorry, not in the example, in the query, whatever you have mentioned, that particular attribute alone will take. If you have mentioned star instead of this product ID and product name, it will retrieve all the attributes. Okay, now can you understand the use of a particular attribute name in under select statement? So this query is selecting the product ID and product name from the product table where price is 10 and 18. Okay, so that two alone will be displayed. Okay, so let's see the next one. That is between with in. The both operators we are going to use in the same query. So let's see what is the example for that. So here I have given the statement which is used to select all the product. Okay, so this query is it will retrieve all the records, all the product. Okay, because I have used star here, so it will select all the products with a price between 10 and 20. In addition, it will not show the product with a category ID of 1. Okay, I have to select all the attributes from product table where the price should be between 10 and 20, and including this, the category ID, which product have the category ID as 1, it should not be displayed. Okay, so if you don't want to display a particular record or a particular value while finding the output or while displaying the output, you can mention that attribute or that value in not in operator. Okay, so if you don't want to display that in your output, you can use not in operator to avoid that. Okay, avoid that value. So let's see this in let's see the output of the given table. So here is the output table for our query which we have written previously. So as I said, we have mentioned the star, right? So it is retrieving all the attributes present in the product table, and the ID, customer category ID 1 will not be displayed. Just look at here, category ID is 2 only, there is no 1 value, and it just giving the values which is not in 10 and 20, right? So here I have given a sample table. Just look at the table. This is your sample database, that is order ID, customer ID, employee ID, order date, as well as the shipper ID. So totally 5 attributes are there. Let's see the queries based on this database. Okay, between dates. So as I said, you can use a between statement for text, number, as well as the date. So we are going to see between dates. Let's see an example for this. So just look at here, this query is selecting all the records. Why it is selecting all the records? Because of the star which we have mentioned in the query. So it selects all the records in order table where the order date between 1st July and 5th July. Okay, the condition is 1st July and 5th July between. Whatever order has mentioned between 1st July and 5th July has to be displayed in the output. The output is, just look at here, it retrieving all the records, all the attributes, and it shows only the order which we have mentioned here. It should be the 1st July to 5th July, right? The first one is a 4th July and the second one is a 5th July. So likewise, whatever we have mentioned in the condition, it will be applied in the given sample database and it will retrieve the output. Okay, so likewise, you have to use this between dates in queries. So I hope this will be very useful for you to understand the operators between and in. And I hope you all understand the topic. If you have any doubts, please go through the video again and again. Then you will get a clear knowledge on this. Thanks for watching. Thank you.